What's up, everybody? Here is your Ross with Boxing Peel, and I have some new news about actually Alexander Povetkin. And that's a tough news to hear, especially if you're a boxer, because you know that this news is going to come, but you hope it's gonna come later rather than sooner, because Alexander Povetkin promoter, which I don't know if I say it right, Ryabinskiy, something like that, say in the boxing scene, in an interview for Boxing Scene, said, "I will persuade Povetkin to end his career." He basically said in the interview that Povetkin looked like a shell of his former self. He's 41 years old. He has accomplished an amazing career in boxing, and now it's time to retire. I think this is the last fight, believes Ryabinskiy. And honestly, I mean, if you think about this fight and the way actually Povetkin looked like, but even the way the guy behaved in the first fight, you can hardly say that, you know, Ryabinskiy is wrong. You know, father time, as everybody says in boxing, it's actually undefeated. You know, you can go long distance with father time, but sooner or later, he's gonna beat you. Like he beats everybody. And the big question is, has time come from Povetkin? But the question is also, you know, we had, if you think about Vladimir Klitschko in his last match against Anthony Joshua in 2018. I mean, guys, he was actually 41 and gave a hell of a match against Anthony Joshua. So it's true that, you know, at 41, the body's in decline, but how long can you keep going? And I mean, never forget about, you know, George Foreman that, you know, became heavyweight champion, I think, at 45. So, has to be this the last of Povetkin match? And especially because when you are at the top player for so many years, if you just have to go midway through the class, in the rankings, you know, it's better to retire, according to everybody. You know, you cannot... You have to stay at the top level. If you cannot stay there, it's actually better that you retire. But one thing is also that, even according to the WBC president, Mauricio Sulman, you know, there may be another reason why Povetkin looked like off from the first moment. Just let's realize, guys, but already the way he was walking into the ring, the way he was fighting already from the first round, that already says something, you know, he had trouble keeping his balance, you know, he was unsteady. So according to also Mauricio Sulman, in another interview that he released from Boxing Scene, he actually said that maybe he didn't fully recover from COVID. Maybe he can get another chance because there was not only age over there in his defeat with Povetkin, but was also the COVID that he wasn't allowed enough time to rest. And especially, don't think about recover from a normal person. You're speaking about a 41-year-old professional athlete that has to bring his body to 200% of its ability. So even if he's slightly off at the professional level like Povetkin is at, that can mess up everything, guys. And the good news is that, you know, Dillian White, he knows that for now, his hopes for a world title championship are completely off. Because, you know, Joshua and Fury, they signed a 2-fight deal that is going to keep them busy at least for 1 year. So he knows he has to fight. And he offered, actually, Povetkin a third fight. You know, and honestly, it's fair. The first one, Povetkin won. The second one, White won. Who's going to be for the third fight? And I mean, the big question is Povetkin going to accept the third fight or retire? Part of me wants him to accept because I want to see that age is only a number, that it's possible to defeat Dillian White 2 times, and not only with a perfect punch, also technically. And on the other hand, I mean, you know, there is a voice inside of you that after you get a beating like that, that says retire. Right, like Vladimir Klitschko, he said, I didn't accept the rematch with Anthony Joshua because even if you have 0.5% doubt that you're not gonna make it, that voice is gonna grow within you, and at one point you just wish that you had retired earlier rather than going out with two defeats in a row. And I think Povetkin is actually going to probably think that, and I don't think he's going to accept the rematch. And you know, he's 41, he was a 2004 Olympic gold medalist, he has made the history of boxing both in positive and in negative ways. So I think it's time, you know, father time decide when somebody retires. And I think father times are decided for Povetkin. But I mean, I thank you very much for following the video. Please don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.